While speaking during the Novel Technologies for Malaria Control Journalist and Target Malaria Engagement at Uganda Virus Research Institute, Christopher Runji, the Field Entomologist Coordinator, Target Malaria Uganda, said the available tools have had challenges of drug resistance and cannot effectively address the issue of malaria. Birunji further explained the status of the current mosquito tools and why genetically modified mosquitoes will be a game changer.
We have a lot of tools to fight malaria. You know of the nets, you know of the insecticide spraying. But these tools, as much as they've done a good job over the years, have reached a point where we are not seeing a lot of reduction anymore. The progress has stalled. And we are still looking at ways which we can reach malaria elimination.
Target Malaria is working in a consortium with other universities and research institutions on the project. The agency is in the initial stages and it has set up an insectary at Uganda Virus Research Institute and also applied for regulatory permission as the stakeholders engagement manager at Target Malaria Uganda, Jude Bajirencha, explains.
Early stages, we have built our insectary at Uganda Virus Research Institute and we have applied for regulatory permission to be able to move to the next level of importing and studying genetically modified mosquitoes within our insectary. This will take some time, studying the mosquitoes in the insectary. Our teams, our entomologists and our professional staff will be working in the insectary to study these mosquitoes to see whether they can actually contribute to eliminating malaria.
The scientists highlighted that the mosquitoes will not only have an impact on malaria, given that they are purely for study purposes until they get to a stage of having genetically modified ones.
Research takes quite a while. And we anticipate that we can be able to import the mosquitoes when we get the approvals from the regulators and then work in containment for more than 2 years and also apply afresh for work that can be done on a confined level to have these mosquitoes, you know, tried on a given area. But these are mosquitoes that do not have an impact on malaria. They are mainly for studies.
Uganda is not a pioneer in the space of genetic modification of mosquitoes. Burkina Faso has already completed the initial stage of sterilizing male mosquitoes.
That were conducted in Burkina Faso were with the sterile male mosquitoes. This was a phase for studies, for capacity building, and for ensuring that the teams can be able to work with genetically modified mosquitoes. They were not meant to achieve any malaria impact. So that study was mainly to see if you conducted or if you did a modification on a mosquito, whether it would affect its ability to fly or even to mate.
Birunji explains why we should care about malaria and why children and pregnant mothers are the most vulnerable.
According to the last World Health Organization malaria report, Uganda had about almost 13,000 people that died of malaria just in 1 year. So we contribute to one of the top 5 countries that is responsible for all malaria in the world. About 50% of that burden of malaria comes from just 5 African countries, and we are one of them.
Malaria remains a big health challenge in Uganda. In 2022, the country recorded a total of 12,651,126 malaria cases and about 17,556 deaths, according to the Global Malaria Report. Story compiled by Agnes Chota Lingerire for the news.